Right, so this is what the, for want of a better word, the kickdown cable looks like when it actuates the valve block. So as you can imagine, there's a cam-shaped plastic part, spring-loaded. As you can see, there's the spring, and you can see the roller on the end of the piston there that goes into the valve block. And this notch here, if you can see that, just doing this one-handed again, let me just move the light down that way. It sits in there. So this notch, this piston here, this extension here sits in the lever of the quadrant. This is first gear position, by the way. First gear position, the teeth are meshed there, and the lever is right on the last detent. So this is what happens. As you'll see, as the kickdown cable starts pulling out, it pushes on that roller, which pushes on the valve inside the valve block. There it goes, and releasing it. Now on kickdown, when the throttle is fully planted to the floor, there's a resistance, and then all of a sudden it snaps right open like that, and then it releases. Obviously this is not ideal because, right, now this is what happens when you move your gear selector. Remember, you wouldn't see this normally. This, the big valve block will be covering this. I'm just showing you what it looks like. So let's just hold that down there. Right, so we're in first gear. Second gear. Third, just make sure that doesn't push up because it's not bolted in. Drive, D for drive, obviously. And then you've got neutral. And you've got reverse. And then park. And this is what the position looks like in park. The teeth are on the opposite end of the position. The detent is on the last notch. And I don't know if you can see down there, but that's part of the ratchet and pull mechanism. So let me just take you down to the deep dark depths of the gearbox. And right, see that little notch at the top left? Just up there, that is the ratchet. This is very strong, designed to hold a 1.6 ton car. Normally the valve, the governor unit will be sitting in this. And let me just move that for you. And if I could just, you'll see that little notch disappear in a minute. He says, he tries to get it moving. There it goes. So let me just put it in park again. Park. So these castellated notches here is what engages with the ratchet. So that is completely locked up because then the ratchet, the pull mechanism, is engaged with those heavy looking teeth. Right, so if you've taken off your valve block and you forgot to make a note of what the position is, this is what it is. So let me just put it back to first gear. And now we're back in first gear. And just to confirm, that's the bell crank. The cable will be attached to that. And that's the kickdown cable. And this is the underside of it. And this is what it looks like without all that gubbins. Right, park position. Just push that down, because if this pops up, it will come out of alignment with these teeth. Just align it and just push it back. Just make sure it's like fully in the proper position when you go and put the valve block in. Otherwise you end up with a gearbox full of first gears and you'll be stuck in first. Or you won't be able to go anywhere. So, again, there you go. It might go a little bit further, only purely because there's no gear lever to finally restrict the movement, but just as a point of reference, there's the last indent or the detent for first gear. The teeth are still in alignment. There you go. So that is what lies under the valve block in your ZF4 HP18 transmission, for front-wheel drive cars at least. I think on the rear-wheel drive cars, this is actually underneath the gearbox, because the engine will be in a north-south position. In front-wheel drive, it's across the car, east-west, transverse. What else to say, really? That's the brake band. And that's the adjuster. I'll just pop that there. I think it's done up to 10 newton meters. You undo that big lock nut, which is tight. You do it up to 10 newton meters, and then you back it off exactly two turns, and then you retighten that lock nut. But ideally, these are tested and adjusted on the workbench when they're attached to test meters and test rigs. What else to say? Oh yeah, just make sure that the cable isn't frayed. If it's frayed, if it's old, it will start binding and it will cause issues. Apart from that, really, although automatics are complicated, this ZF4 is probably quite a simple automatic, relatively, I'll say. There are far more complicated engines out there, or gearboxes, and later gearboxes have valve blocks, but they have they have solenoid valves and motors and actuators and things like that. I think the HP20 fitted to certain Xantias and XM, V6 XMs, I don't know. But the HP20 has electromechanical solenoids among the valve block. So that's completely different. So I hope you found this useful. And like I say, just because if your gearbox is showing symptoms of a worn governor unit, just be prepared. It doesn't necessarily make it just that only that problem. I had those symptoms on the old gearbox, and it's obviously other issues with it. But hopefully, if you're lucky, it'll just be the governor. It'll just be the governor seals, the O-rings on the back side of that one, and the car will be back on the road. But on my one, the second gearbox was also playing up, despite it being rebuilt. And so the valve block had to be taken out and cleaned out. Just hoping that's all it needed. What else to say? Yeah. Alright, this is just a quick overview, just for fun. Let me just hold that down there. Obviously in first gear, you can rotate the governor. Let's put it in park. In fact, I can show you exactly what park looks like. Hang on, stand by it. Maybe not, hang on. There it goes. Now that's in park. Let's release it again. And it rotates.